oldest, Gage, who is 9, has ADHD. My middle child, who is a girl, she's 6, she has autism. And then I have a 5-year-old, Gavin, who has not been diagnosed with anything on the spectrum, but you know, he still lives with us and kind of lives this life with us. My name is Katy Hebebrand, and I have 3 wonderful children.
What is that a picture of?
Done.
What is that a picture of?
Done.
Good job.
Our kitchen table is really not a meal kitchen table. It's really more of an activity kitchen table. We pretty much always have markers, crayons, craft supplies out, because as far as like sensory input, one thing I've learned is with kids on the spectrum, sometimes they need sensory input to help them regulate. A big thing for me is that I feel like kids are gonna be kids, and I feel like so many times parents or adults expect kids to sit still.
Mommy, hold this hand. Look how long it could stretch. No, but. Whoa! It can stretch very long.
I think the biggest hurdle is constantly feeling like you're not adequate and like you're not doing enough. You know, they may respond better to a teacher versus mom. And so I really had to separate out that, hey, right now I'm not your mom, I'm your teacher. And sometimes we would get frustrated with each other.
I'm just gonna say for myself, when I got out of school, I would just be sad, because I just felt like the work was hard. It was basically just because I had ADHD.
So Gage, after starting to homeschool him, he stopped being as angry all the time, even before he started taking medicine for his ADHD, just because there was so much less pressure on him.
I could get my work done quicker and whenever I wanted to.
The biggest thing that I would want people to know about neurodiversity is, you know, a lot of people hear that and it's kind of like taboo. But these kids are so smart, and they just learn differently, and they just have, you know, it's challenges that we all struggle with. Maybe we all struggle to sit still, or maybe we all struggle to focus sometimes. For them, it's just amplified. And when you take into consideration that kids on the spectrum are often feeling bombarded by sensory, by lights, by sounds, by people touching them, by movement around them, it just amplifies the struggle for them.
Pigtails are 2. Ponytails are 1. You got it? And braids are braids that go twist, 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 twist. And a bun is a big old circle. Got it?
Gabby is mild to moderate on the autism spectrum. She struggled with speech at first when she was little. We got her into therapy very early, and she has really just excelled. The specific struggles with her that she gets very easily frustrated, and so a lot of times we have to take so many breaks and just go do something different and come back to it, and I really just have to trust that it's absorbing a little bit at a time. I just really want them to enjoy learning. To me, that's what's really important. I don't put a whole lot of pressure on them to make straight A's. I don't put a whole lot of pressure on them to like just excel and do super well and be the best in the class. To me, it's just, I want them to do well. I want them to do their absolute best. At the end of the day, I want them to enjoy learning. I want them to either want to learn through homeschool, want to learn at public school, private school, whatever it is. I want them to enjoy it. I want them to learn.